Hey beauty, so I'm coming to you guys with this brand new video. If you hear a noise in the background, it's my fan because this light is really hot. So yeah, I'm coming to you guys with this brand new video. It is on this look. It is my fall look. And you guys seen me use this lippy before. It's my Lime Crime lipstick in the color Salem. Not the regular lipstick, like the liquid lipstick. Yeah. Anyway, this is a collab video with my girl Tammy Clark. She's from the UK and she's so dope. I hope you guys enjoy her video. Check it out. It's in the description bar below. And yeah, like, comment, share, subscribe, follow me on Instagram and Snapchat. All of that will be in my description bar as well. And I'll see you guys later.
So I'm just priming my T-zone with my Makeup Forever mattifying primer, and this is just to keep the oily areas mattified for as long as possible. And for the surrounding areas of my face, I'm using the Smashbox Photo Finish Oil-Free Primer. Lord, the name's too long, Smashbox. Anyway, I'm using my pore minimizing primer for them as well, and I'm filling in my pores and I'm just rubbing that in, and I'm doing the same to my laugh lines. And I'm also priming my lids with my anti-aging eyeshadow primer from Urban Decay. So I'm just using the applicator to apply it and then just rubbing it into the lids. And then I'm using my LA Girl Pro Conceal in the color Toffee, and I'm using a blending brush to apply it to the lid. And then I'm going to go in with some translucent powder from Laura Mercier just to set that, just to set the concealer in place. So my transition shade for my eyeshadow is going to be Morocco from the World Traveler palette from Anastasia Beverly Hills. I cannot explain how much I love this color. I honestly only like three colors out of the whole palette, but that's why I'm honestly keeping it. And then I'm using Soft Peach to apply to the lid. I realized the only way the color was really showing up is if I was using swiping motions instead of patting. It was really, really weird. But anyway, I'm applying that to the lid, and I'm trying to make sure the color is as vibrant as possible because the color payoff is not that much. And then to go into that crease, I'm using another fluffy blending brush. Jesus Christ. And I'm going into the color Fudge. And I'm just using a big fluffy blending brush, the same one that I used before, and I'm just blending everything together. And I'm going back in with my lid color to make sure it is as vibrant as possible, because once you put a setting spray, everything just blends in together for the lid. So yeah. Then I'm spraying my face with my Smashbox primer water to just renew all the primers and everything. And then I'm going to use my color corrector, which I mixed the orange corrector from LA Girl Pro Conceal and the foundation in Soft Sable from L'Oreal Infallible. And I'm just going to blend it under the eye area and above the lip with my fingers. And then I'm going to go in with my trusty beauty blender. And for foundation, I'm using the same mix I did before, which is the Liquid Halo from Smashbox and the Makeup Forever Ultra HD. This is literally my go-to foundation as of right now, and it's so lightweight. I could go on and on about how amazing this foundation is, but anyway, I'm applying it with my beauty blender so that it looks so gorgeous and skin-like. And then because this foundation is dewy and I have oily skin in certain areas, I'm just going to set around my laugh line area because it tends to sink in to those areas. So I'm just, you know, setting it, making sure it doesn't sink in so quickly. And for concealer, I'm actually using my LA Girl Pro Conceal in the color Fawn. And when I use this concealer, I like to apply it with my finger and blend it out. And then use my beauty blender. And it blends so seamless and so perfectly. And the coverage is amazing and beautiful. And I feel like that's the best way to use this concealer. And of course, you guys know this routine. I'm just going to set the under eye area with my Laura Mercier Translucent Powder. And I'm just going to highlight the rest of my T-zone and of course set it with my Ben Nye Luxury Powder in the color Banana. To contour, I'm just using powder. Usually for the fall, I contour with concealer, then set with powder, but it's still a little hot out in New York, so I'm just gonna contour with some powder, and I'm using my Fit Me foundation in number 360. And then I'm just gonna clean that up with the same powder, my Ben Nye Luxury Powder and Banana. And back to the eyes, I'm going in with the same color again, Soft Peach from the World Traveler palette. And I'm just packing that onto the lid. I really want this color to show. And for my wing liner, I'm using my Tardiest liner from Tarte. And this is where all the hard chips start with my makeup. The top pops off. So that was my last time using bad eyeliner. It sucks. But my face was completely priceless. Like, that's why I kept it in the video, because it was so funny. And then I'm using Noir from the same palette. And I don't know, I was just going with the flow. It ended up being a cut crease out of nowhere. But I'm adding that to the outer corner and into my crease. And I'm just using the brush from the palette to blend it out. And then back into Fudge with a smaller blending brush. And I'm going on top of Noir just to make sure it blends out. And it looks seamless. And then I'm going in with my fluffy brush because it blends everything out so easily and so nicely. I'm back in again with the lip color. Guys, literally eyeshadow takes me about like 30 minutes. It takes me forever because I need everything to look blended and neat. So I just keep going back into everything over and over again until it's perfect. So sometimes when I want that extra budge proof wing liner, I would set my gel with a liquid. So I'm just setting it with my Kat Von D Tattoo Liner and Trooper. Then I'm just going to dust away all that banana powder. And I'm using the brush that I was using to contour before because it's very dense and it picks up product. So I felt like it was better to dust away all of the excess powder. And it gets worse, guys. I break my foundation powder. Oh boy. But I gotta keep the show on the road, so I'm using whatever the remainder is of that powder to go over the highlighted areas so they are not so yellow. So we're going to bronze up the face a little bit more and contour again with my Fit Me foundation powder in the number 360. I'm getting the forehead region and the cheek area. And most importantly, you gotta make sure those brows don't move. So we're just setting them with the clear brow gel from Anastasia Beverly Hills. And then I'm applying my lashes. I'm using the Au Naturel 02 from Kiss Eye Envy. I call these my Bambi lashes because they're so fluttery and cute. And then I'm using no liner in my lower lash line, just some shadow. And I'm using Morocco from the palette, and I'm dusting over the whole lower lash line. And then I'm using fudge in the outer area to the middle of my lower lash line. And then for blush, because I do wear blush in the fall and winter, I'm just using a little bit of my Sephora Collection blush in Sweet On You. And then I'm just spraying my face with some Fix Plus, and I'm using my highlighters that I use in every video, my Gold Deposit from MAC and both highlighters from the Missy Lynn palette. And then I'm going in with my mini of the roller lash from Benefit just to define those lower lashes. And you guys know I'm going to use my Cary Grant lip whip to moisturize my lips. And then I'm lining with my brown lip liner. It's not a deep brown. I don't like deep browns for my lip liners. And then I'm using my Lime Crime liquid lipstick in the color Salem. I'm applying that all over the lip. Last winter and fall, this was like my color, and I just wanted to bring that back for this video because I was so in love with it. And then I'm just going to clean up any excess product that got in areas it's not supposed to be in with my foundation and an ankles brush.
This video, like I told you before, like, comment, share, subscribe, follow me on Instagram and Snapchat. Check out Tammy's video and subscribe. I promise you guys, she's extra extra dope. I would not tell you guys to check anybody's page out if they weren't. And yeah, see you guys in my next video.